MashaAllah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala sayyidina al-mursaleen. Amma ba'd, fa'audu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Inna allahu malaikatu yusalluna ala al-nabi, ya ayyuhallazina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina maulana muhammadin wa ala sayyidina maulana muhammadin, barik wa sallim salli alayhi. Allah, brother Shoaib aur Haji Safdar Hussain sahab, mashallah, tamam hazrat jinhone shirkat ki, jo shirkat kar chuke hain, jo sun rahe hain, tamam hazrat ko mashallah Eid Milad al-Nabi mubarak ho. Allahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his mercies upon this blessed mehfil and upon all the listeners and ummat al-muslimin. And may Eid Milad al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mubarak be upon you all. Ameen. After praising Allah Almighty, sending salutations upon the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and wishing you all, Milad al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wish you all assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace, mercy and blessing be upon you all. Ameen. So, mashallah, Brother Shoaib, mashallah, once again, mubarak bas to you for mashallah presenting a beautiful mehfil on this blessed night of the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal Sharif. Mashallah, the blessed night. Due to this night, the creation became into existence. Otherwise, there would have been no creation. There would be nothing. Subhanallah, because of the beloved Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created his light, the beloved Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's light, and then from that light, he created his beloved messenger. So everything was created from that unto Ulima teaches us. So the beloved is the purpose of a creation. And this is why we celebrate the blessed night and the blessed month of Rabi'ul Awwal Nur Sharif. So as brother, mashallah, Shoaib Sahib mentioned that we are not the Ulima, mashallah. Today, the Ulima are very busy, mashallah, in every masajid. There is Noor, there's Ronaka, in every, there's Barakat, blessings, and there's mashallah, celebrations are taking part. The Ulimas are busy, but mashallah, they have been coming, taking part in this mashallah programs of Brother Shoaib, who has been presenting in this blessed month of Rabi al Nur Sharif. May Allah accept him. Ameen. And mashallah, may Allah bless Brother Shoaib by his household with the blessing of this blessed month, and all the people who have taken past Ulima, the Sana Khan-e Mustafa, and the people of whoever has been listening, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them all. Ameen, Ya Rabbana, Ameen. So we're going to do a short dars, inshallah, and then I will conclude with dua. So alhamdulillah, as soon as the month of Rabi'ul Awwal Nur Sharif came upon us, alhamdulillah, and whenever it comes upon us, subhanallah, it seems that the springtime blossoms everywhere. Subhanallah, those who love the beloved and the blessed Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam become excited and delighted. Every true Muslim, whether young or old, expresses the feelings of his heart as if, subhanallah, nisar teri chal par par azare ide rabbil awwal sharif. Siwai iblis ke jahan mein sabhi to khushiyan mana rahe hain. Subhanallah. And look at the meaning of this, mashallah, couplet. Thousands of Eids be sacrificed on the reverence of Rabi'ul Awwal Sharif. Everyone is rejoicing in the world except Satan, Shaitan, the cursed Iblis. As Brother Shoaib, mashallah, early recited this couplet as well. So when the darkness of disbelief, this is why we celebrate this blessed night, and this is the why it's most important to celebrate this night. Because when the darkness of disbelief, kufr, idolatry, and barbarism prevailed everywhere in the universe, what happened? A light shone in the sacred house of Sayyidina Amina radiallahu anha in Makkatul Mukarrama, which brightened the entire universe. The Prophet of Rahmah, the intercessor of Ummah, the owner of Jannah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, for whom the troubled humanity was anxiously waiting, came as a universal mercy for all the world. Subhanallah. Mubarak ho ke khatam al-mursaleen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam tashreef le aaye hai. Janab-e rahmatil alameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam tashreef le aaye hai. So congratulations upon you all. The last Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam has come. Congratulations, the mercy of the worlds has come. Subhanallah. Then, so why wouldn't we celebrate when the mercy, rahmatul alameen, has been descended and on this blessed night and made all the universe lit up, subhanallah. So the dawn of these blessings, subhanallah, the Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam came into the world on the 12th of Rabi al-Nur Sharif. Why we say Rabi al-Nur Sharif, meaning the month of light. Yeah, the month of light, because the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came as in a human bashar. He came as a human bashar, Abbas, by his asal. His reality is light, subhanallah. Of course, we believe him as a human being, as all prophets were sent as human beings. But there is no one like this human being, subhanallah. And asal, reality is light as well, subhanallah. So we believe in both. So, mashallah, when this night came, this dawn, the blessed dawn, what happened? The dark nights of miseries, difficulties, troubles, tribulations ended in becoming bright and special and auspicious dawn of blessings, subhanallah. So children were gay, girls were, astaghfirullah, in jahiliyat, were being buried alive. Women had no status, they were treated worse than animals. There was slavery, there was inhumane action, immodesty, kufr, there was barbarism. People treated others as mere cattle, people, racism, and all sorts of evil was everywhere. And the beloved message of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam descended. And subhanallah, and this way we say, Muslimano, subh-e bahare mubarak ho aapko. Wo barste anwar sarkar sallallahu alayhi wa sallam aaye hain. Congratulations on the onset of this blessed dawn, our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has come showering nur and light, subhanallah. We're going to mention a few miracles, subhanallah, which took part on this blessed day. Soon as Allah azawajal's nur, the beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, twinkled on the earth on the 12th of Rabi al-Awwal, the dark clouds of oppression, the misery and zulm, oppression and disbelief, kufr disappeared. The palace of Kisra, which belonged to the Iranian king, was struck by an earthquake and 14 of his spikes fell off. The flame, which had been continuously blazing for 1,000 years in Iran, extinguished any the people who worshipped the fire. That 1,000 years they were worshipping this fire and extinguished in Iran. The river Sawa became dry. The Kaaba began to sway and the idols fell on their heads. Because at that time in Jahiliyyah, after Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, and after that, there was no between Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and then Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, then there was a gap between Hazrat Isa alayhi salam and our beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Holy Imam said approximately 600 years there was a gap. So in that between time, there was a few, like the family of the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Pak parents, the blessed parents of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they were there, and there was a, they were believed in Islamic monotheism, because there was nothing, no Sharia to follow anymore, because it's been such a long time between the Prophet of Allah Isa alayhi salam and the beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Apart from that, many started believing in idols, so they filled the Kaaba with idols. And on this blessed night when the beloved was born, subhanallah, upon this night, upon his arrival, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Kaaba swayed, every idol fell trembling, being afraid, subhanallah. Beyond doubt, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent as a mercy. Mercy, and indeed the day when Allah azawajal mercy descends is a day full of happiness and joy. Allah azawajal says in the Holy Quran, part 11, Surah Yunus, قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ بِرَحْمَتِهِ وَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, Allah's munificence and His mercy, upon these should their people rejoice. Subhanallah, that when Allah's mercy and munificence descends upon you, upon these should the people rejoice. That is better than all the possessions. Allahu Akbar. The Quran in itself is ordering us to rejoice over Allah's mercy. And there is Allah's Azwajal's mercy. There is no mercy of Allah Azwajal greater than that in the form of the merciful Prophet Sallallahu Ta'ala Alayhi Wa Sallam. The Holy Quran has clearly announced in para 17, Surah Al-Anbiya, verse 107. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ Subhanallah. And we did not send you by the mercy for all the world. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Brother Shaim, is saying that بِفَضَلِ اللَّهِ بِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبَذَّلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا وَخَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ Allah himself is saying the munificent and when my munificent and mercy upon these should people rejoice. And this is better than all their possession. Then who are we to say there is no importance of 12th Rabi'ul Awwal? There's no importance of Rabi'ul Awwal Sharif. And this is